So what drew you to the project at first? Was it the script? Was it the pedigree?
I mean, the people behind it was just, you know, who wouldn't want to go in on it? And then for me, it was like, as soon as, you know, I got the job, it's just finding out, oh, by the way, Giancarlo's in it. Oh, by the way, Billy Burke's in it. And, you know, then meeting Tracy.
That made you back off.
No, I got you. I'm right there.
Oh, was it the first one?
So who wants to boil down the premise for folks who don't know anything about it?
Giancarlo.
Oh, wow. Thanks so much. Well, the piece to me is, and what attracted me to it was the idea of a new world that reflects an old, very primitive world as well. But moving us into the future, it's 15 years after the blackout, and we go back to a time where we didn't have all the technical ability. The power goes out. And so we're all left in the dark in many different ways, and we flash back to that and to that day, and we're trying to figure out what this new world is, and we are in a world that is completely devoid of power, so we have to find new ways to survive. That's one of the things that attracted me to the project, was that it was about connecting with people again. You have families trying to connect with each other.
There are flashbacks throughout the show to sort of, along the way, bring us up to speed what happened during that 15-year gap.
And what is sort of the rule book for what elements of technology are still allowed to be used in this new world? Like, does a potato battery work? Does anything?
Nothing works.
As far as we know, yeah, the rule is nothing works.
Nothing works.
Yeah.
Car batteries, nothing.
People may be still carrying iPads and iPhones in the hope that one day the power could be restored and they might be able to see photos of their families again, or be able to connect with the music that they once loved, or remember their child's faces. But those devices are basically dead.
Yeah, they've become meaningless. I mean, they use, like, the Volkswagen Bug is like a carriage, you know, pulled by horses, and probably an iPad is like a little coaster or something, you know?
You know, a lot of serialized shows have gotten somewhat of a bad rap lately because, you know, some of them, viewers feel like the producers don't know where they're going with it. They're making it up as they go along. Did you have an assurance going in that sort of JJ and Eric had a firm plan? You know, and they don't know what the hell they're doing.
I think we find it as we go.
Yeah.
But I think one of the things that attracted us all was that this team is a brilliant team, not only creatively, but also intellectually, if they're of thinkers. And I think that they put their time in to be able to figure out what these stories might be. They've at least assured me that they have some incredible storylines coming up.
You're playing another seemingly menacing character coming off of, you know, Breaking Bad, obviously. Congratulations on your Critics' Choice
Award, thank you,
by the way.
Thank you.
How is this character different or similar to Gus?
Well, you know, I try to create every character is new. I think this guy is not going to be a guy who's going to tell you a bedtime story. I think he's a little bit of a loose cannon in certain areas. He's a master manipulator, but he's fun. I think a lot more fun than Gus. I think he's able to really read people very, very well, and he uses that against them and sometimes for them. But I think he does have some compassion somewhere in there. I think Neville is a guy who wants to protect that last piece of purity that's left in the world.
Any Breaking Bad fans here?
I think we're all Breaking Bad fans.
Were you intimidated, freaked out meeting him for the first time?
I told him right away, man, it's an honor. Like, this is... I mean, he's done so much work. I mean, theater and film, and he's just incredible, so.
We actually met years and years ago on a pilot that we can't remember the name of. it was, I don't know, probably, what, 10, 11, 12 years ago, something like that. But we had met before, but I was, you know, when I heard he was in this, I'm like, what better choice is there?
Yeah. And the nicest human being ever. As soon as I met
it's
him,
a little
I was like,
bit
hi.
Ridiculous.
Like,
hi. How beautiful.
Big hug. I was like, oh yes, you're the best.
Oh, thank you.